Hello, and welcome to the Panther News Network. I'm Carlton Lawrence.
I'm Jalen Spice, and here's what's going on today.
5 years ago to the day, Miles Scott, who was battling leukemia, became a real-life superhero when he got dressed up as Batman to take down Penguin and the Riddler in San Francisco as part of a touching request made through the Make-A-Wish Foundation. The city's police and fire departments, the San Francisco Giants, and the late San Francisco Mayor Ed Lee granted 5-year-old Miles wish by turning the city into Gotham, allowing the brave little boy to fight crime and rescue the Giants mascot Lucille. Miles affectionately became known as Bat Kid following his special day. Now, at the age of 10, Scott is cancer-free after being in remission for the past several years, Make-A-Wish Foundation said in a statement Thursday. He finished his last treatment in November of 2013, right before he became Bat Kid. Since his crime-fighting day 5 years ago, Miles has returned to being a typical kid, playing Little League, going to school, helping his family farm, and even selling his first market goat in a local fair, the organization said in a statement. Miles' wish not only granted national headlines, but also caught the attention of then-President Barack Obama, who sent him words of encouragement. A special edition of Gotham City Chronicle was also released by the San Francisco Chronicle, declaring Bat Kid saves the day. Miles still has to visit the doctor once a year, but the organization said he is doing great.
A New Jersey woman was arrested after 44 dead dogs were found stuffed in plastic bags and stored in freezers at a Shamong Township home, state police said Wednesday. The grim discovery led to authorities charging Donna Roberts, 65, with animal cruelty. An additional 130 dogs were found inside and outside the home, living in what police described as deplorable and inhumane conditions. 4 of the dogs were taken out of the home in critical condition and to an emergency veterinary clinic, the New Jersey State Police said in a statement posted on its Facebook page. The remaining living dogs, all various types of breeds, were treated at the house by animal shelter workers and later removed. Detectives were called to Roberts' Oakshay Road home on Tuesday to help the Burlington County Health Department with an inspection when they noticed signs of animal cruelty, authorities said. Burlington County Prosecutor Scott Coffina said the health department was at the home because of the township's newly adopted law concerning the housing of animals when investigators became concerned about the welfare of the dogs. We are appalled by the horrendous conditions these dogs were subjected to, he said in a statement. There was also an odor of animal feces and ammonia coming from inside the house. State police said the smell was so strong it made several of the responders to experience dizziness and nausea. Roberts was released from jail Tuesday pending a court date, authorities said.
And we'll be right back in a moment with more words from our PV News.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We rely on your support to help us with our motto, all out, all game, all season. Your contribution is the home run we need.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
I'm Vernon Bland, former student athlete and baseball Hall of Famer. I now have the honor of serving as a softball coach at our alma mater. We charge our student athletes every day to strive for excellence, and they have met the challenge. Now it's your turn.
We need you to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Hey, Panther Nation, it's Coach Tacho Tyler, 2-time Hall of Famer and current head volleyball coach here, and we need you guys to support the Panther Excellence Fund.
We need you. Support the Panther Excellence Fund.
As a 12-time champion, as a former student athlete, assistant coach, now head coach, I've witnessed firsthand how teamwork creates success. We need your support to help propel us to new heights.
Hi, I'm Eric Dooley, Prairie View new head football coach. Prairie View Panthers has a historic tradition of academics and athletic success. Panther Nation, it's time to focus on the acronym WIN. What's important now? And what's important now is each of you to join and support the Panther Excellence Fund.
Your gift is vital to help us achieve our goal on the hill. Help us win today by sending in your contribution.
Prairie View A&M University, we've been igniting passion in students for more than 140 years. It's about inspiration. It's about global influence. It's about self-expression and individuality. It's about trailblazing a path of excellence. It's about engaging in the greater community. Above all, it's about helping you realize your dreams. Ignite your passion. Experience Prairie View A&M University.
Traditions are not made overnight. They are created through a legacy of excellence and a commitment to something much greater. For more than 135 years, Prairie View A&M University has provided students with a strong academic foundation, a unique college experience, and the opportunity to make their mark on the world. This is a place where friendships are formed, discoveries are made, and dreams are realized. This is Prairie View A&M University, our tradition, your opportunity.
Prairie View A&M University is about the students. Students don't just come here for the education. They come for the faculty, for the creativity, the camaraderie, an excellent standard of living, and the school spirit. They come here to gain something profound and to give something back. Students come for the tradition of excellence. This is Prairie View A&M University, our tradition, your opportunity.
Welcome back. It's finally warming up in Prairie View according to the weather rep today. The high is 70 degrees and the low is 46. Expect even higher temperatures going into Thanksgiving weekend, but a 40% chance of rain on Sunday.
A man accused of shooting and killing two black people at a Kroger grocery store in Kentucky last month was charged with multiple hate crimes on Thursday. In a six-count indictment, a federal grand jury charged Gregory Allen Bush, a white man from Louisville, of gunning down Maurice Stallard, 69, and Vicki Lee Jones, 67, at the store in Jeffersontown, Kentucky, a suburb of Louisville. He faces two counts of a hate crime resulting in death and an additional count of hate crime with an attempt to kill. The other charges were linked to gun crimes. If convicted, Bush faces life in prison without parole and could be subject to the death penalty. The Justice Department has declined to say if it plans to pursue such a punishment. Bush, 51, had attempted to enter a predominantly black church in the area on October 24th, but couldn't get in, police said. Authorities said he then drove to the Kroger and walked by dozens of white shoppers before shooting the victims due to their actual or perceived race and color, the indictment said. A witness also claimed Bush said whites don't shoot whites while he was walking through the store. There is no place for hate-fueled violence in this community and no place in this commonwealth, Russell Coleman, the U.S. Attorney for the Western District of Kentucky, said in a statement after the charges were filed. Bush has already been charged by a state prosecutor for two counts of murder and 10 counts of wanton endangerment, which also carry a possible death sentence. He pleaded not guilty to some of those crimes on November 2nd, and acting Attorney General Matthew Whittaker called the act horrific in a statement on Thursday and said the country cannot and will not tolerate violence motivated by racism. We will bring the full force of the law against these and any other alleged hate crimes against fellow Americans of any race, Whittaker said. Jeffersontown Mayor Bill Dierruff told CNN that the shooting was a heinous act the community would not stand for. A crime against race is something that we will not accept, he said. If it's a hate crime, it's unacceptable to us that a crime would be committed against a race. Certainly against any nationality or race is heinous.
A Mexican citizen on death row in Texas was executed Wednesday night for the sledgehammer killings of his wife and two children more than 26 years ago. Roberto Moreno Ramos was condemned for the 1992 deaths of his 42-year-old wife, Lucida, 7-year-old daughter, Abigail, and 3-year-old son, Jonathan, at their home in Progreso, located along the Mexican border. When asked by the warden if he had a final statement, Ramos thanked the Mexican consulate for his assistance with appeals in his case and said he was grateful for the humane treatment I got in the prison in Texas. I'm getting my gold watch that it took the governor 30 years to forge, he said. Thank you, God. Lord, send me the chariot. I'm ready. As the lethal dose of powerful sedative began taking effect, Ramos took a couple of deep breaths, sputtered, and began snoring. Within seconds, all the movement then stopped. 11 minutes later, at 9:36 p.m., Ramos was pronounced dead. Mexican officials had called for Ramos' execution to be stopped, arguing he was part of a group of Mexican citizens condemned in the U.S. who were told when first arrested that they could get legal help from the Mexican government. The U.S. Supreme Court cleared the way for the punishment Wednesday night when it denied two appeals seeking to halt the execution. Ramos' attorney on Wednesday asked the Supreme Court to stop his execution, arguing that Ramos' consolation rights were violated as lower courts refused to fully review his claims that his trial lawyers failed to present any evidence about his mental illness and abusive childhood that he could have persuaded jurors to spare his life. Three retired justices who had served on the Texas Court of Criminal Appeals filed court documents to the Supreme Court on Wednesday in support of stopping the execution. The ex-judge's alleged appeal court appointed to uncompliment appellate attorney who early in the post-conviction process failed to investigate Ramos's case. Also Wednesday, a federal judge in Austin dismissed Ramos' request to temporarily block the execution. The request had been part of a lawsuit Ramos filed against the Texas Court of Criminal Appeals a day earlier. The suit alleged the appeals court had not allowed Ramos to present claims he had an effective trial and appellate lawyers. The Texas Court of Criminal Appeals and the Fifth U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals had previously turned down requests to halt Ramos' execution. The Texas Board of Pardons and Paroles on Monday declined to recommend either commutation of Ramos' sentence or a six-month reprieve.
The Panther Ambassadors will be hosting Spin Knowledge in the MSC Auditorium this Saturday, November 16th at 5:45 p.m. right after the football game. The lecture will include radio and television personality Charlamagne Tha God, who will discuss his newly released book called Shook One and other relevant topics. All lectures are free and open to the public, and to enter, you will need a wristband, which should have been distributed in the MSC since Wednesday. Don't miss this good conversation.
Thank you for watching the Panther News Network.
See you next week, and have an amazing weekend.